Hi everyone, welcome to my channel and I am Subhash Chandran. In this video, I am going to show you the 5 inevitable habits to be cultivated to become successful in our profession, in piping design engineering profession or piping engineering profession. I am not sure how this is going to be useful for engineers who are working in other engineering domains, but however, if you are into a mechanical engineering domain, whichever one it is, these 5 habits will really be useful to become successful in your profession. But especially when it comes to piping engineering has certain roles and responsibilities that demands these 5 habits. That's one of the reason I wanted to emphasize on these 5 habits, that if you are able to have these habits in your life, then nobody can stop your growth and nobody can stop you from being successful. So without wasting time, let's get into the video. Before getting into the topic, we should understand how useful it is to become successful. So let me share my own experience. During my initial days of my career, I was having a good knowledge and I was having a really good experience, but still I was not able to understand what is going wrong with me, why I am not getting the recognition that I was expected to get. I was always complaining about the appraisal or the salary increment. I was most of the times I was complaining. I was not able to understand why it is. So finally, I could see no growth at all. So this, I believe this happens to everyone's life, and being a beginner with less than 4 to 5 years of experience or 8 years of experience, I know that most of us go through this phase of life. But once after having this habit, and after bringing this habit in life, this is what happened to me. I know what is right and what to be done in life and how to become successful and what is the key thing to be done to become successful. And then naturally these habits helped me to stop complaining about the circumstantial crisis. And the third important thing is that after that, I could see a phenomenal growth in my life and as well as in my professional life very particularly. So that is why I am sharing this 5 habits that I have really felt this is useful for you if you wanted to become a good engineer, an engineer who can get a good recognition and who wanted to become successful in life. Now let me list down why it is exactly important. The first thing is to become successful. We all want success and we wanted to become successful in life. In whichever profession we are, we wanted to become successful. So especially for piping design engineers, like all other engineers, we also wanted to become successful. So that's why I truly felt that these 5 habits will really help you to become successful in your professional career. And second important thing is that it improves your focus. Focus on your profession, because that is where the success naturally comes, right? If you don't have a focus on your job or don't have a focus on your work, we can't expect the success to come to us. So this improves your focus. And third important thing is that you can deliver better. Even you can deliver better than expected. Because if you are going to deliver better than your expectation, definitely you will be recognized and you will have a better growth. And the fourth one is recognition. These 5 habits will give you such a recognition that no one in your office or no one in your profession can get. If you have these 5 habits, these 4 things that I've listed over here will definitely come into your life and you will perform better than others. Now, immediately this thing will come in our mind. What if I don't have these habits, or what may happen if I'm not going to have these habits in life? So let me list down what you may get to face in life if you're not going to have these habits. The first thing that is going to experience is that you're going to believe on your luck. You have to wait for your luck, because since you do not have these habits, you do not have any other option. You have to wait for your luck. If you're not lucky, definitely you're not going to be successful. And the second thing is that you will see a poor growth in your professional career. Like your peers will grow better than you. You won't see a much phenomenal growth in your professional life. You may see a marginal growth, but it would be lesser than your peers. And you will not have much support from your fellow colleagues or your peers, because since you do not have these habits, it is more likely that you are not going to get any support from your colleagues. And the fourth one is that you will be ignored. You will be ignored in the sense for any new opportunities or any for rewards or anything such. You will be completely ignored if you are not going to have these five habits. This is what I have experienced, and this is what I have really and truly learned from my personal experience. So I'm just sharing these five habits. I believe that these five habits will really be useful for you or to become successful in any professional life, and especially in piping engineering profession. What are the habits? Let's see one by one. The first habit is interest in technical reading. This is where most of us are lacking, just because at the beginning stage of career, we don't show much interest in technical reading like standards and codes and materials or any technical paper. We are more interested in reading non-technical commercial current affairs or novels or something like that actually, but we don't show the same interest in going through or reading the technical books or standards basically. So if you are not going to read the technical subjects, you are not going to improve, or you are not going to increase your subject knowledge. And more importantly, you will not be knowing about the requirements that are listed in the standards in which you are working. So this particular habit is really important. You have to cultivate a habit of going through the technical documents, reading standards and codes, and understanding in the way and understanding the requirements that are listed. So you have to have these habits to be successful. Habit 2, maintain and take notes. This is one of the necessary and the important habit that every piping design engineer should have. You know why it is? Because being in a piping discipline, you may have to face lots of meetings, you may have to face lots of clients, and you have to discuss with many parties, and you have to do lots of actions in a daily basis. Generally, piping engineers get too many actions in a daily basis. So it is always wise enough to make a personal diary to maintain all the actions in terms of notes, so that you can always go back to your personal diary to check what was discussed and what was agreed, and you can take actions accordingly if something is pending. But if you're not going to maintain a notes, what will probably happen is that you may not be able to recall or remember what was discussed with the different disciplines. So you will miss out an action. So this will highly impact your reputation, and if this gets repeated, the internal growth within the company for you will be highly questionable. So it is really necessary to take notes for every actions that you are doing in a daily basis. Habit 3, analyze and verify the fact. Being a piping design engineer, it is our responsibility to ensure that whatever design that we are delivering to the client should meet the requirements of the client. We should not go with the basis of word of mouth from your friends or colleagues or from your superior, because even your superior cannot be right at all situations, even he can go wrong at times. So it is your responsibility to check whether whatever thing that you have mentioned or whatever thing that you have drawn, is it meeting the requirements, or you have any references from where you have verified it. So this is what one of the important habit that being a piping engineer should have, because if you are not going to deliver something which is not verified with the technical documents or the standards, you will not be able to prove that your design is right. So you always have to analyze and verify. You should not just go with the word of mouth, especially in design engineering. Everything has a minimum requirement, everything has a standard, everything has some conditions. You have to check and verify the fact whether whatever design that you have made is right or wrong. Habit 4, respect and recognize others' knowledge and wisdom. Nowadays, most of us are obsessed about our own knowledge, and we often forget to respect and recognize others' knowledge and wisdom. Habit 4, respect and recognize others' knowledge and wisdom. Nowadays, most of us are obsessed about our own knowledge, and we often forget to respect and recognize others' knowledge and wisdom. Especially for those who are working below us, and we don't respect their views, we don't respect their ideas, and we don't respect their opinion even. By doing so, you are not only ignoring them, but you are also ignoring their ideas. You may not know that who will come up with the best ideas. Even a simple idea can change your life. If people feel that you are a person that they can share anything to you, the more people will come to you for discussion, and more discussion that you are going to make in any technical topics, you will get lot of clarifications and your knowledge is going to go up. This is one of the important thing. If you are going to respect and recognize others, people will come to you for more technical discussions. They will share their ideas. If you are making mistakes, and they will openly come and approach you to correct you. If you are a person that who don't recognize others, nobody will support you in case of crisis. Habit number 5, responsible communication. Being an engineer, the first quality that we all should have is that being responsible. And we should reflect this quality in every aspect of job. We should communicate on time. We should send the response on time. We should interact with different teams on time. We should collect the input on time. Basically, in most of the projects, 60% issues are only because of improper communication. If somebody has done his communication or her communication properly, most of the problems would have been solved. So being an engineer, we should always remember that our actions are very much important. So for every mail, there must be an appropriate communication on time. And we also need not to be emotionally connected with others' words. Actually, I could see that most of us are showing their anger in mail or emotionally writing because that somebody hurt them. See, being a profession, we should maintain the dignity of that profession. We should write and we should always see in a professional way, or even if somebody is reactive, you have to deal with them in a very professional way. So engineering is a very highly responsible profession. So every communication needs to have some responsibility, and you have to show your responsibility in everything that you do, every part of your job. Actually, communication is one of the vital part of a job. So if you are able to communicate with the highest responsibility, and most of your problems will be solved in job. So all these 5 habits will really help you to become successful in life. Believe me that I have followed all these 5 habits. I was able to achieve what I was not able to achieve earlier. So believe me that these 5 habits will really help you to become successful in life. I will meet you in another fantastic video. Until then, bye from Subhash Chandra.